Today's devotion from Charles Spurgeon is entitled Pray for God's Ministers. Our scripture comes from 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 25. Brethren, pray for us. This one morning in the year we reserve to refresh the reader's memory upon the subject of prayer for ministers, and we do most earnestly implore every Christian household to grant the fervent request of the text first uttered by an apostle and now repeated by us. Brethren, our work is solemnly momentous, involving wealth or woe to thousands. We work with souls for God on eternal business, and our word is either a savour of life unto life or of death unto death. A very heavy responsibility rests upon us, and it will be no small mercy if at last we be found clear of the blood of all men. As officers in Christ's army, we are the special mark of the enmity of men and devils. They watch for our stumbling and labor to take us by the heels. Our sacred calling involves us in temptations from which you are exempt. Above all, it too often draws us away from our personal enjoyment of truth into a ministerial and official consideration of it. We meet with many complicated cases, and our wits are at a nonplus. We observe very sad backslidings, and our hearts are wounded. We see millions perishing, and our spirits sink. We wish for you to profit by our preaching. We desire to be blessed to your children. We long to be useful both to saints and sinners. Therefore, dear friends, intercede for us with our God. Miserable men are we if we miss the aid of your prayers, but happy are we if we live in your supplications. You do not look to us, but to our Master for spiritual blessings. And yet how many times has he given those blessings through his ministers? Ask then again and again that we may be the earthen vessels into which the Lord may put the treasure of the gospel. We, the whole company of missionaries, ministers, city missionaries, and students, do in the name of Jesus beseech you, brethren, pray for us.